Hey there, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we're going to talk about converting between the different units used to measure the volume of liquids. In our last lesson, we filled out this chart for cups, pints, quarts, and gallons. And we discovered when we're moving from cups to pints, we can divide by 2 to find how many pints. And when we're moving from pints to quarts, we can also divide by 2. And when we're moving from quarts to gallons, we discovered we divide by 4. So that's us going from smaller to larger in our units. But if we're going to go the other way, if we're going to go from gallons to quarts, we would have to multiply by 4. So 1 gallon is equal to 4 quarts. So I have to multiply by 4 to get to quarts. Now if I have 4 quarts and I'm going to pints, what do I have to multiply for? 4 quarts is equal to 8 pints. So that means 4 quarts times 2 would tell me how many pints I have. And if I'm going from pints to cups, if I have 8 pints and that's equal to 16 cups, I have to multiply by 2 again. So these numbers here are called conversion factors. And conversion factors are numbers or fractions that are used to help us convert between units. So remember when we use these pictures to help us figure out our conversions, so we could rewrite these as our conversion factors. So 2 cups is equal to 1 pint. So if I have 2 cups and I'm converting to 1 pint, remember I have to divide by 2. But dividing by 2 is the same as saying 1/2 times 1/2. So this 1/2 is actually 1 pint over 2 cups. So this picture is saying this conversion factor. And this picture, remember if I'm going from pints to quarts, I divide by 2, and that's the same as multiplying by 1/2, but that 1/2 is actually saying 1 quart is equal to 2 pints. And now for this one, if I'm going from quarts to gallons, remember I have to divide by 4, and that's the same as multiplying by 1/4, and that 1/4 actually means 1 gallon is equal to 4 quarts. So these fractions here are my conversion factors when I want to find the top numbers units. So here, do you see we have our conversion factors, these fractions here? And we know what these fractions really mean. It's saying 1 pint is equal to 2 cups, 1 quart is equal to 2 pints, and 1 gallon is equal to 4 quarts. Now everything is 0 here because we're starting with 0 cups. I have this here, I'm going to change the number of cups and we're going to see how they all relate to each other. So if I change this here, let's say 2 cups because we know this one. 2 cups is equal to 1 pint. And 1 pint is equal to, well, we have to multiply it by our conversion factor, which says 1 quart is equal to 2 pints. So if I multiply 1 times 1/2, I get half of a quart. Now if I have half of a quart, I have to multiply it by my conversion factor, 1 gallon over 4 quarts, and I get 0.13 gallons. So let's increase it again. Let's go all the way to 16 cups. So here I have 16 cups. If I multiply that by my conversion factor of pints and cups, I have to multiply by 1/2. Or 1 pint over 2 cups. 16 multiplied by 1/2 is the same as dividing by 2. I get 8 pints. Now if I have 8 pints and I want to convert it to quarts, now I have to multiply it by my conversion factor of quarts and pints. It's important to notice here that we have pints on the bottom of our conversion factor. Why? Yeah, because I need to cross out my units here to leave me with just quarts on top. And now if I'm converting 4 quarts to gallons, I know there's 4 quarts in every 1 gallon, or I can use my conversion factor and divide 4 quarts by 4 quarts, and I get 1 gallon. So let's do this example together. It says, how many quarts are in 10 pints? So we're converting pints to quarts. So I'll write down what I know, 10 pints. And I wanna know 10 pints is equal to how many quarts. So I need a conversion factor that will have pints to quarts. And that is this one here. 1 quart is equal to 2 pints. Now notice when I do my multiplication with my fraction here, I can cancel out my pints unit. So I'm left with just quarts up here, which is good because that's what I want in my answer. And so now I have 10 over 2 quarts is equal to 10 divided by 2 is 5 quarts. So here I have a trickier one. It says, how many gallons are in 40 cups? So I'm converting from cups to gallons. We write down what we know, 40 cups, and I'm going to convert it to gallons, so I need to multiply by my conversion factor. But do you know a conversion factor for cups to gallons? Well, all we really need to know is this right here. 1 gallon is equal to 16 cups. So our conversion factor is 16 cups over 1 gallon. But to do this here, I want gallons as my answer. I need cups on the bottom, so I'm going to have to flip this fraction over. So I'll have 16 cups on the bottom, 1 gallon on top, and I'm going to go ahead and do this multiplication. I know I can cross out my cups, and I end up with 40 gallons over 16. So now this looks like a division problem, right? I'm going to just go ahead and use my calculator. 16 goes into 42 and a half times. So 40 cups is equal to 2.5 gallons. Awesome job learning how to convert between these units of volume for liquids. Practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.